Hello, so today I wanted to show you really quickly how to install and use ChartJS in React. And I'm going to do this with an example using a bar chart. So ChartJS is really cool because when the values change of the data, it animates, and it's a very smooth animation. And so along with that, there's a whole bunch of built-in charts and graphs, and they all look super nice and are super easy to use and style. So, and they have loads of options as well. So let's get started here. So first thing you need to do is you need to set up a React app. And so I've already done this, and you can go ahead and set up a React app however you like. And then once you do that, you're gonna have to install the ChartJS and React ChartJS too. So if you follow along with what I'm doing here in the terminal, you do npm install dash dash save chart.js react dash chart js dash 2. Go ahead and run that command, and that will install the two different packages that you need. And then when you come up here to the top of whatever component you're gonna create this chart in, you're gonna import the type of chart, and I'll leave a link to the table of contents of their documentation that shows you all the different types of charts and graphs you can use, and gives you examples of how to do that. So I'm going to use a bar, so I'm going to do import bar from React ChartJS 2. And then you have to also import a few things to register here to chart. So you're going to import chart as ChartJS. So you don't have to do as ChartJS, but I do, because that's what the documentation does. So that's what I picked up. Category scale, and this is, I don't know why, but you need category scale, and you also need linear scale. Now, a few of them, you have a few other options. Oh, sorry, you need bar element as well. And so I suspect that's only for the bar chart. Now, there's a few other options that you have. I'll add them in here. Actually, I'm gonna exclude title, but I'll add tooltip in there. You know what? I'm gonna add title as well. So you have tooltip, title. Actually, I changed my mind again. I'm gonna exclude title here. You can do legend if you want. We'll do legend. Legend. Perfect. And this is gonna be imported from chart.js. Now what you're going to do is you're going to do chart.js, which remember is chart imported as chart.js, and you're going to register all these things. I'm going to move these onto a separate line here, actually, so that it's easier to see. Perfect. So everything that we've imported there, we have now registered. And remember, this is required. The tooltip and legend are not required, but category scale, linear scale, and bar element are required. Perfect. So let me show you how to use the actual component here. So now that we've imported bar, we can go ahead and make a component just like this. It's just called bar with a capital B. Super easy, and you pass through a prop data, which is going to be an object here, and I will show you the options. So let's GitHub Copilot is eager to get going. You can see labels is going to be one option. In this case, GitHub Copilot is correct. We're going to map the users. And what we're going to do is return user.name. So basically, what this does, it just goes over our list of users here and it returns their name. And so this is going to return an array as a whole. So labels has to be an array of strings. Maybe it accepts numbers. I'm not quite sure, but I do know it accepts strings. So if I were you, I'd pass it through strings, which I suspect you probably will anyway, if that's what people use for labels. So moving on to the next part, you get data sets. So data sets is going to be an array of objects, and I'll show you the options for data sets as well. Perfect. So in these objects, you're going to have a few options. You're gonna have label. You're gonna have which will go into the legend, and you'll see where that goes. You're gonna have data, which will be the actual data that you're gonna be displaying. That would pa be passed through as an array, of, I suspect, only numbers in this case. And again, this is only for bar chart. There's completely separate, well, not completely separate. Most of the charts and graphs have the same data sets. There may be different data set or structures for the data sets for different charts and graphs, but that will all be shown in the documentation. It's super easy to look up. Their docs are great. Background color, which is going to be the color of the actual bar in the chart for this specific data set. The border color, which probably be the border as well, border color of the of that specific bar, and the border width. So let's go ahead and set perfect. Go have Copilot on it, and then the data. So we're gonna feed through items delivered. So I have two sets of data here actually for each user. I have items delivered and I have miles driven, just random data I made up for delivery drivers, I guess. So the first data set we're gonna use is items delivered. So let's see in a bar chart who delivered the most items or how many they delivered. And they're gonna give us, looks like a red color here. So let me get rid of the opacity, just so it's easy to see. Perfect, that's fine. We don't need to add border color or border width. There's tons of options for data sets, for properties to feed through to the bar. So you feed through options, which has a whole set of properties that you can add there. And then data has its own options as well. So super, super versatile package. I suggest you go through the docs and see what fits best with what you're trying to do. So this is our first data set, and this should bring up a solid chart. So let's take a look. Let's refresh that. Oh, got to start the React app here. There we go. So exactly as described, the tooltip that we registered shows up here when you hover. So pretty much exactly what we're looking for. And you can see up here the little legend. It says items delivered. Oops. I have no idea what I did there. I guess I stopped the display of that specific data set. So you can see the grid lines are here. On some of the graphs and charts I've used, I've turned the grid lines off. It's pretty easy to do. All sorts of different options that you have. Now, one other thing I want to show you is using a second data set. So let's go ahead and copy this data set over, and we'll change it from items delivered to miles driven. It's already got it. And then miles driven. And let's see, it's probably going to come up with blue. Perfect. Blue's awesome. So now you'll have two data sets, and you can see up here in the legend, it'll show you the data sets and the items delivered. And then one last thing I'm going to show you really quickly. I'm going to go ahead and make a little interval here to update data, and I'll be right back and I'll show you what it looks like updating. Okay. So I've set up a little use effect and interval here, as well as moved the users to a state. Again, none of this matters for the demonstration here. All I'm doing is showing you when the data is updated and passed back through again. So in this case, using a state, this re-renders automatically. Kind of looks like, let me refresh this. And it's going to look a little weird actually because they're all being updated. And you can barely see that. Let me move this up to... let's see, 10. You should be able to see it better now. Perfect. So you can see how the animation smoothly moves the bar up. And the reason why it moved back down there was because the graph expanded because it's getting too big for it. So perfect. You can see how to use an animated bar chart or other kinds of charts or graphs using ChartJS in React. I hope that helps. Thanks.